Let's head around the Inside Politics table, ask our great reporters to help get you out ahead of the big political news just around the corner. Maeve Rustin.
So everyone's focused right now on Indiana, but we are looking ahead to my home state of California. And once again, the question is the fact that Ted Cruz has been organizing there a year ahead of time really going to put Trump at a disadvantage? They've got to go into all of these blue districts. It's winner take all by congressional district. And we're talking about finding Republican delegates in Maxine Waters' district in order to send a loyal slate to the convention. So that's going to be fascinating to watch. Can Donald Trump get his delegate game together in California?
And the California primary matters. Almost never does. Does this time, Jeff?
Primary colors, and in the Clinton campaign's case, that's green. They're still trying to raise primary dollars, but they are about turning the corner to the general election here. They're about to start raising money for the general. Not quite yet, because they still want to wring out a few more of those primary dollars. She'll be campaigning and raising money later this week in California, in Texas. Some donors are clamoring to start to raising money for the general, but the Clinton campaign wants to raise a few more primary dollars. This is significant here because in 2008, she raised both at once, primary and general money at the very beginning. This year, they only raise primary dollars. So it has actually forced fundraisers to look farther down to find new donors. They've done that. They're about to turn the corner, but not quite yet. They need just a little bit more of that green.
A little bit more cash to spend before the convention. Manu?
John, the other big primary in Indiana on Tuesday is the Senate Republican primary. That's between Marlon Stutzman, the congressman, and Todd Young, the other congressman. And Stutzman, of course, is a member of the conservative House Freedom Caucus. He voted against John Boehner. And who doesn't want him to become a senator? Senator Mitch McConnell, the majority leader, who his forces are spending a ton of money to stop Stutzman in the primary. They've unleashed a barrage of attacks, as Super PAC has. There have been negative stories, Oppo Research stories, that have hit Marlon Stutzman. And I'm told by McConnell allies are very confident that Stutzman is going to lose and that Todd Young will be the nominee after Tuesday. And what's interesting about this primary fight, it's less about electability and it's much more about personality.
Mitch McConnell continuing to try to crush the Tea Party, carrying that one over. Sarah?
Well, back on the presidential field, we've all been following the fight for delegates, but we have to remember that not all delegates are created equally. So the Trump campaign believes they have lots of different ways to get to 1,237 before Cleveland, but what they are really focused on are these bound delegates. We made a big deal out of Pennsylvania about all of this wooing of the unbound delegates, and yes, that's important, but what's more important is bound, because that is how the RNC tracks who the nominee is. The Trump campaign wants 1,237 bound delegates as soon as possible because they want to be able to exert as much control as possible over the convention ahead of time.
Which is why Indiana and then California, New Jersey, West Virginia, a lot to count still. Sarah, thank you. Let me close with an observation or two from a quick visit to Mexico City this past week. I was there for an event Thursday night, had conversations with a mix of young professionals and older Mexican business leaders and diplomats. Most striking, how closely, extraordinarily closely, they are following our presidential election. Donald Trump, of course, is the principal reason why. To a person, those I spoke with were horrified at his tone on immigration. And every conversation included a question about whether Trump is a really viable candidate to win the presidency. Yes, he is. But it isn't just Trump and his immigration views that are making our neighbors to the south more than a little nervous. Trade between the United States and Mexico has more than tripled since the NAFTA agreement was implemented in the Bill Clinton presidency. And the much more negative tone about NAFTA and future trade deals, not only from Trump, but also Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders, is raising serious worries about the future of a business relationship our neighbors believe is not only good for both the U.S. and Mexican economies, but they say the major reason the pace of illegal immigration by Mexicans has slowed considerably. Trust me, the world is watching. That's it for Inside Politics. Again, thanks for sharing your Sunday morning. We'll see you soon, including for our special Indiana primary coverage Tuesday night. Up next, State of the Union with Jake Tapper.